Hi, I'm Scott Hammond with writtenplan.com, and today I'm going to talk to you about procrastination. Let me start with a story. This is a story of a young girl named Madai. And Madai was in fifth grade, and she was an awesome student. She was always on the honor roll. They had her wall covered in awards, and every time at the end of the semester she would come home, let her father know that she had achieved the honor roll. And it was good times at her house because she was brilliant and her wall was decorated. Except for this time. For whatever reason, Madai got a B+ on this test and it just didn't go perfectly. And she came home and she, instead of a blue ribbon, got a red ribbon. Well, her dad grabbed that out of her hand and he said something that rocked her world negatively and probably produced a perfectionist procrastinator for the rest of her life. He snatched that ribbon, he took it over to a shredder, he stuck the ribbon down in the shredder and shredded that red ribbon and said 11 words that probably transformed her life negatively. He said, "We have no use for that color in our home." Wow. I'd like to talk to you about procrastination. Two of the major sources of procrastination are, number one, lack of clarity. Many of us, we don't know what it is we're supposed to be doing. And how could you get clear on what it is that you're supposed to do? Well, sometimes it just starts with asking. Vague priorities will not do. Sometimes we need to get out and ask the question and get clear. And most people in most circumstances are pretty reasonable human beings, and they'll tell us what it is that we need to know. Number two is task-related anxieties and avoidance issues. In other words, is it too difficult? Is it too unpleasant? Is it too boring? Well, a lot of things in life are, and those are things that sometimes we have to deal with. So let me ask you, what's your story of procrastination? What is it that keeps you from being the most productive, organized, and focused you that you can possibly be? Are you a perfectionist? I married a perfectionist and she has to have everything right before it happens. And that's okay, I love her, but that's the way she's wired. Are you a procrastinator? Do you put things off, hoping they'll go away and they only get worse? And how could you take that knowledge and be aware of that? Because remember, awareness is the first step in dealing with change. If you can be aware of that behavior, you can change it a lot quicker because you're highlighting it all the time and you can see it. So who's in charge of your behavior? When you're under stress, when you're overloaded, when you're in freak out mode, we all default to our default behaviors. So whether that's procrastinating, whether that's web surfing, whether that's networking and talking and carrying on and being a distraction or distracted, we all default to those behaviors when we're under stress. So how can you slow down and engage your thinking brain? Well, number one is that you can develop good habits. In other words, you can have that 96-minute window every morning, 2 or 3 hours, whatever you want to do, where you're really focused on mindful multitasking. You're not doing 18 things and bright and shiny objects. You're focused, you're in the moment, your door's closed, and you're doing the main thing. Number two, you could actually have clearly defined desired results. When you have crystal clarity on what's expected and what you want to accomplish, that's 95% of the battle. When you know what it is that's needed to be done, then you can bring all the resources together and do that incrementally, sequentially, methodically, a little bit every day. The Japanese call that Kaizen. You're moving the ball forward a little bit every day. And then lastly, can you stay focused and not be distracted by bright and shiny objects? A phone ringing, a text message, an email. Turn the dinger off on Outlook. You don't need it. You can check Outlook. It's not going anywhere. So could you be more intentional about not being a procrastinator? And some of the solutions that you could bring to bear? Could you be more intentional about not procrastinating? Let me offer a couple solutions that might help you. You could master mindful multitasking. What do I mean? You could block out 96 minutes every day to do the main thing. Close the door, shut the curtains, put a sign on your door, turn off the computer, and do the main thing. Number two, you could conquer mental and physical clutter. You could organize your office. You could have neat files. You could be completely, totally dialed in your office and know where everything is and where everything goes. Number three is you could use simplified prioritization. You know every day what the top three or four tasks are. Number four, you could actually have the rational use of time where you could eliminate, delegate, or abbreviate in your use of time and be more effective with that. And number four, you could actually become a more effective learner and become a genius in your field of influence. That way, you can become faster, bigger, better, badder, and do what you do with more intentionality, more results, more efficiency, might I even say elegance. And then lastly, you can avoid avoidance strategies. When you catch yourself avoiding something, regroup, sit down, write out the top 10 things you have to do, then ruthlessly kill 80% of those and do the top two. This will take you to that place of keeping the main thing as the main thing. This is Scott Hammond with writtenplan.com, wishing you a productive day.